Good evening and welcome to 6 p.m. Prime, coming to you live from the national capital. We are standing outside Vigyan Bhavan, where the eighth round of talks between the farmers and the government has just ended. And the news coming in right now, ladies and gentlemen, the eighth round of talks between the reporters, between the farmers and the government of India has remained inconclusive. The problem is that the farmers have continued to stick to their demand of repealing the three laws. The government focus today was only at this point of time on the MSP demand that the government has been making, it has been in fact agreeing to in fact move on to. The government also made it very, very clear that they are not going to move an inch as far as the repealing of the farm laws is concerned. So the latest coming in that the next round of talks, the only good thing at least from this meeting has been that the lines of communication, the channel of communication between the farmers and the government still open, as the next round of talks is going to be on Friday, January the 8th. And till then, the problem, at least in the eighth round of talks, there hasn't been any conclusion or any substantive movement as it was seen in the last meeting. Not a very long meeting today. Let me just show you. Dinesh is going to just give you a sense. Farmer leaders are now coming out as far as the meeting is concerned. They're coming out of the venue of the meeting. And, you know, right now, of course, hectic media activity here as well. A lot of people trying to get in a voice from the farmer leaders of what happened inside. But what we have been told by sources is that today it was a lot of confrontation between the government and in fact the farmers. No one moving an inch from their stated position today. Unlike the last time, there wasn't a shared langar or the ministers coming in and eating with the farmers. Very clear that the government feels that they are moving from their position by accepting two of the demands last time. But the key issue of the three farm laws and the MSP still hanging as far as the government and the farmers is concerned. Remember, ladies and gentlemen, it's been now 39 days. The farmers have been braving the winter cold and the rains as well. But at least today, no conclusion in this meeting. Anand Patel, my colleague, joining us with more details on this story. Anand, this time... okay, before I get in, Anand, Rahul Srivastav, let me just, wait for a second to get a confirmation about my colleagues who all are, in fact, with me right now. And we will, in fact, go to our colleagues in just a minute. All right, Anand and Rahul Srivastav with us. Anand, you've been tracking this entire meeting for the last few hours. Today, it wasn't the same sort of, you know, intention or at least the approach from the government as we saw last time. A very hardened approach where they very clearly mentioned, the government clearly mentioned, there is not going to be any movement as far as the repealing of the laws is concerned. They're ready for amendments.
Yes, live. Yes, absolutely. Ankit, I'm joined by Hanan Mulla, prominent left farmer union leader. Mr. Mulla, around, more than 3 hours of talks over there, but nothing coming out of it yet again.
You know, for the time being, nothing came out. But we, farmer organization, very firmly said that we have no other agenda but repeal, repeal and repeal. They said, you go and discuss. We have enough discussion. So we have nothing to discuss. We have reached a conclusion. We cannot go home. Even leader cannot go home without repealing, because every farmers individually want repeal of the act. So that we firmly said, government understood, and government is under tremendous pressure. So they said, okay, on 8th we'll discuss it. After repealing procedure, then we can go for the MSP discussion.
In the last meeting, there was some headway. Two of your demands were accepted.
But those are peripheral demand. Government said 50-50. That is not 50-50. That is peripheral demand. They are not our main demand. During discussion it came, so government do that. That is 5%. 95% is these two demand. So only 5% was there. That is not main demand.
What was the government stand? What was the minister saying when you said that repeal, repeal, repeal is the only stand of the farmer union?
Government understood they have no other way. They are under tremendous pressure and we'll force them to repeal.
All right. And what is the agenda for the 8th, sir?
8th, oi. First the repeal of these 3 acts, then MSP.
All right, so there you have Ankit Ananmula, prominent left-wing farm union leader, clearly spelling out the agenda of the farmer unions, that their agenda is repeal, repeal, repeal. That means they will not accept anything less than repealing of the 3 farm laws. And then MSP is the next agenda, and this is what they want
right
on the 8th when the meeting resumes. Back to you.
Okay, Anand, stay on with me. Let me go across right now to Rahul Srivastav, National Affairs Editor, India Today, joining us on the broadcast. Rahul, the sense after almost 40 days of this protest, which is going on the borders of the national capital, at least from this meeting, which is trickling down now, is that the government is also hardening its stance. The government feels that the farmers are not moving as much as the government is to try and negotiate.
Ankit, I will say that the government is basically following a twin track as far as dealing with the farmer protest is concerned. At one end, we are seeing that there has been a distinctive change as far as the body language and the language for negotiation by the government is concerned. If you recall, Rajnath Singh, the defense minister, a few years back said that the farm protesters should not be treated and labeled as Khalistani. Today in the morning, there was a condolence meet for a few minutes for all the farmers who have perished during the tenure of this long drawn protest. That was the kind of overture the government gave. In the last meeting, on two elements, the government said that it is ready to step back. But on the other hand, when it comes to the core issue, as Mr. Ananmula was saying, that on the peripheral issues, the government seems to be relenting. But on the core issues, the government does not seem to be backing down at all and is entrenched as far as the stated position is concerned. And that's why, Ankit, today in the afternoon, when the meeting broke for lunch, till the time there was discussion only, but there was no concrete step forward. After the lunch break, there was a long period in which there was no talk. The government representatives led by Mr. Narendra Singh Tomar were sitting in a lounge area. They were discussing, strategizing for what one doesn't really know. The farmers were waiting for the talk to happen. And after that, they went in the room. The government wanted that let's discuss a point by point, have a point by point discussion. While the farmers were saying repeal and MSP, just discuss these 2 points. When there was no consensus, eventually the meeting broke down. And then the government came up with a proposal, let's meet again on the 8th. So what one can say is that the government is remaining equally relenting, despite giving the posture that it is actually ready to listen and it is subject to the demands of the farmers. And that's why something concrete now is needed, because the government had back on the ball, because on the January 20th, the farmers are saying they will march effectively.
Okay, Rahul, stay on with me. I'm just coming back to you. Let me just check if Kamaljeet is with us, because Kamaljeet right now is trying to speak to the farmer leaders, those who have come out of the meeting. Kamal, if I can very quickly come to you, what are the farmer leaders saying? I mean, last time they said that if this meeting comes out without any concrete movement forward, they are going to increase their protest.
Well, we are inside the bus which will take the order. Significantly, these leaders are coming out of the meeting. Some of them obviously extremely disappointing. The others saying they only expected this particular thing coming out of the meeting. Sir, result to kuch nikla nahi, sir.
Result kuch nahi nikla. Sarkar kole koi daleel hai nahi si. Unhone 8 tarikh mangi hai, 8 tarikh nu phir aamange.
Aap log borders pe hai aur phir 8vi baar aap aa rahe hain sarkar se milne ke liye.
Aayenge.
Kitne कितने मुश्किल है आपको लग रहा है कि सरकार
का जान दे गुप्ता
सरकार से क्या उम्मीद कर रहे हैं?
सरकार से उम्मीद रखेंगे, क्योंकि कानून सरकार ने कैंसिल करने, हमने तो करने नहीं। हम तो आंदोलन कर सकते हैं, आंदोलन कर रहे हैं और वो उतना चिर जारी रहेगा जब तक सरकार मांगे।
वो अपनी बात पे अड़े हैं, आप अपनी बात पे अड़े हैं तो
कैसे? अड़े नहीं गए, हमारी मांग ये है, हमारा आंदोलन इसी पे खड़ा है। कानून रख दिया जाए।
टोटल केओस, बट लेट्स जस्ट ट्राई एंड गेट इन।
ਸਰਕਾਰ ਕਾ ਵਤੀਰਾ ਡਬਾ ਹਮ ਨਹੀਂ ਹਣੇ ਚੰਗਾ ਮੈਂ ਤੁਸੀਂ
ਚਲੋ ਆ ਗਿਆ
ਗੈਟ ਮੋਜਾ ਪਲੀਜ਼ ਸਾਈਡ ਤੇ
ਲੈਟਸ ਜਸਟ ਟ੍ਰਾਈ ਐਂਡ ਸ਼ੋ ਯੂ ਦ ਫਾਰਮਰਸ ਟ੍ਰਾਈਂਗ ਟੂ ਗੈਟ ਔਨ ਦ ਬੱਸ ਐਂਡ ਹੇਅਰ ਵੀ ਆਰ ਵੀਲ ਸ਼ੋ ਯੂ ਦ ਬਰਡਸ ਆਈ ਵਿਊ ਰਿਮੈਂਬਰ ਦਿਸ ਇਜ਼
We are just going to come back to you, but before, in fact, let us now go across and listen to Agriculture Minister Narendra Singh Tomar, who is speaking at this moment.
आज किसान यूनियन के साथ चर्चा हुई और भारत सरकार के दो कानून नए और एक संशोधन ऐसे जो तीन कानूनों के बारे में चर्चा चलती है उस पर हम लोग चाहते थे कि यूनियन क्लॉज वाइज चर्चा करें जिससे कि उसमें से रास्ता निकालने में आगे बढ़ सके इसी पर बात चलती रही थोड़ा बहुत बात एमएसपी पर भी हुई लेकिन आज हम कोई निर्णय तक नहीं पहुंच सके और इसलिए यूनियन और सरकार दोनों ने मिलकर तय किया कि 8 तारीख को पुनः 2 बजे बैठेंगे और इस चर्चा को आगे बढ़ाएंगे चर्चा में स्वाभाविक रूप से माहौल अच्छा था लेकिन एक्ट रिपील पर अड़े रहने के कारण कोई रास्ता बन नहीं पाया लेकिन मुझे आशा है कि जिस प्रकार की बातचीत आज हुई है उस हिसाब से अगली बैठक में सार्थक चर्चा होगी और संभवतः हम लोग समाधान तक पहुंच पाएंगे
सर किसान लोग बोल रहे हैं कि हम आप सरकार के ऊपर भरोसा नहीं करते सरकार हमें
देखिए अगर सरकार पर भरोसा नहीं होता तो 8 तारीख की बैठक क्यों तय होती सरकार और यूनियन दोनों की रजामंदी के कारण ही 8 तारीख की बैठक तय हुई है इसका मतलब किसानों का भरोसा सरकार पर है और सरकार के मन में किसानों के प्रति सम्मान और संवेदना है
सर बैठक से बाहर आने के बाद किसानों ने कहा है
कि आपसे एक डिसीजन लेने के लिए आपसे एक नेगोशिएशन में पार्टिसिपेट करने के लिए
क्या
किसान कितना कमिटेड है आपसे फाइनल डिसीजन लेने के लिए
नहीं मैं समझता हूँ चर्चा जिस हिसाब से चल रही है उसके आधार पर मैं कह सकता हूँ कि कुल मिला के किसानों की मान्यता ये है कि सरकार इसका रास्ता ढूंढे और हम सब लोगों को आंदोलन समाप्त करने का अवसर
सर आगे फाइनल डिसीजन लेने की बात थी सर 4 तारीख को हम भी ये चीज सोच रहे थे और किसान भी इसी मूड से गए थे लेकिन फिर 8 तारीख की डेट मिल गई इसकी क्या गारंटी है कि 8 तारीख के बाद फिर 14 तारीख की डेट ना मिले अगली डेट ना मिले
देखिए आप कुछ भी सोचने के लिए स्वतंत्र हो लेकिन मैं कुछ भी सोचने के लिए स्वतंत्र नहीं हूँ इसलिए जब इस प्रकार के विषय होते हैं तो निश्चित रूप से चर्चा के कई दौर करना पड़ते हैं समस्या के कानूनी पहलुओं को भी ध्यान में रखना पड़ता है पूरे देश को भी ध्यान में रखना पड़ता है देश में करोड़ों किसान हैं उनकी अपनी भावनाएं हैं उनके कानून के लाभ और हानि और हित उससे जुड़े हुए हैं तो सरकार तो देश भर के किसानों के प्रति प्रतिबद्ध है ना तो सरकार को जब कोई निर्णय करना है तो निश्चित रूप से सारे देश को ध्यान में रखकर ही निर्णय करेगी
सर किसानों से कहा है कि 8 तारीख को जो बैठक होगी उसमें कानून वापस कैसे लिया जाए इस पर क्या ऐसा जो किसान कह रहे हैं वो ऐसा सही है
देखिए दरअसल क्या है जब चर्चा होती है विषय दो ही है मुख्य रूप से कानून और एमएसपी तो चर्चा मैं बीच बीच में चर्चा आगे बढ़ती है फिर पीछे जाती है फिर आगे बढ़ती है फिर पीछे जाती है तो ऐसा कुछ नहीं है कि हमने कुछ इस प्रकार से कहा हो लेकिन कुल मिला के चर्चा ठीक वातावरण में हुई और दोनों तरफ से उत्सुकता है कि जल्दी से जल्दी इसका समाधान निकले
सर किसान कह रहे हैं कि लोग बात नहीं माने सरकार जो है जब बातचीत में शुरू में ही मंत्री ने एक तरह से साफ कर दिया कि किसान बिल जो है कानून जो है वो वापस नहीं होंगे तो फिर बातचीत का क्या मतलब सिर्फ तारीख पे तारीख दे रही है सरकार
देखिए दरअसल क्या है कि सरकार ने कानून बनाया है और सरकार ने कानून बनाया है तो किसान के समग्र हित को ध्यान में रखकर ही कानून बनाया है लेकिन किसान के प्रति भारत सरकार नरेंद्र मोदी जी का नेतृत्व पूरी तरह संवेदनशील है। जब किसान आंदोलन पर हैं और सरकार किसान यूनियन के साथ चर्चा कर रही है, तो हमारी अपेक्षा है कि यूनियन की तरफ से वो विषय आए जिस विषय में किसान को कोई परेशानी होने वाली है, तो सरकार खुले मन से उस पर विचार करने को तैयार है।
7 मीटिंग हो गई है, अभी तक कुछ रेजोल्यूशन निकल करके नहीं आया, तो क्या स्ट्रेटजी गवर्नमेंट की गलत है या फार्मर्स रिलक्टेंट है कि वो बैकडाउन नहीं करेंगे?
अभी अगर आप बता पाए, अभी 8 तारीख को 2 बजे बैठक होगी, उसमें चर्चा आगे बढ़ेगी।
सर एक इम्पोर्टेंट सवाल ये है, हाँ, फार्मर्स चेंजिंग द गोल पोस्ट।
एक ऑब्जर्वेशन ये था कि सरकार इस पर विचार करे कि एक कमेटी का गठन हो, तब तक इसकी लॉज को होल्ड पे रखा जाए। क्या इस बारे में सरकार ने कुछ सोचा है? क्या इस बारे में भी कोई सजेशन आया?
मैं समझता हूँ न्यायालय के विषय में कोई टिप्पणी करना इस समय उपयुक्त नहीं।
सर अभी तक कोई रास्ता नहीं
है, मतलब आराम से पूछो ना, चिल्ला क्यों रहे?
अभी तक इतनी मीटिंग हो रही है, getting delayed and extended. Are farmers changing the goalpost? That is the reason why their negotiation is getting delayed and extended.
नहीं, ऐसा नहीं है। किसान यूनियन लगातार चर्चा कर रही है और जब हम तारीख तय करते हैं तो किसान यूनियन की रजाबंदी से ही तारीख तय करते हैं। हम अपनी तरफ से तारीख नहीं देते।
सर तारीख तो बहुत सारी तय हुई, लेकिन सारी तारीख तय होने के बाद किसान बाहर आके कहते हैं कि बात वहीं के वहीं अटकी है और जब तक बिल वापस नहीं होगा तब तक हम पीछे नहीं हटेंगे। तो अगर ये बिल वापसी पे ही अगर ये अड़े रहे तो फिर सरकार का रुख क्या होगा?
मुझे लगता है जल्दी समाधान होगा। स्वाभाविक रूप से रास्ता निकलने के लिए तो तालियां दोनों हाथ से ही बजती है ना।
सर एमएसपी पे आपने क्या ऑफर किया है किसानों को? क्या बातचीत हुई थी जो आप बता रहे थोड़ी देर चर्चा एमएसपी?
देखिए जब चर्चा सिरे नहीं चढ़ती है तब तक कोई भी निर्णय नहीं होता, और निर्णय नहीं होता तब तक आपको बताया नहीं जा सकता।
आप कई किसान संगठनों से बातचीत कर रहे हैं जो बिल के कानून के समर्थन में है, लगातार अनुरोध देते हैं, क्या फिर से आप उनके साथ कोई एक साथ बैठकर कोई बातचीत करेंगे क्या इन किसानों से बातचीत करने के पहले या फिर
स्वाभाविक रूप से हम देश भर के किसान संगठन जो अप्रोच करते हैं सरकार को, हम उनसे भी मिलते हैं, क्योंकि भारत सरकार तो सभी किसानों के लिए प्रतिबद्ध है, इसलिए हर किसान को भी मिलते हैं, किसान यूनियन को मिलते हैं, संगठन को मिलते हैं, और निश्चित रूप से देश भर का जो मानस बनेगा उसके हिसाब से निर्णय की दिशा आगे बढ़े। ठीक है,
माइक आप लो हमारे साथ बात करो।
Okay, so that was Agriculture Minister Narendra Singh Tomar speaking after the meeting with the farmers. This was the 8th round of meeting between the government and the farmers, and this one remained inconclusive. In fact, if you the news which is coming in right now, the farmers unions have said they are going to meet tomorrow to discuss what their strategy is going to be from here on. Remember, ladies and gentlemen, that the farmer unions had already said that if on the meeting which held today, on January 4th, if there was no conclusion to the meeting, no positive movement forward in the meeting, then they are going to increase their entire protest, which has been going on for the last 39 days. So tomorrow is going to be a very, very crucial meeting. What would be decided? Because the farmers, last time when they spoke, they had already said that they will escalate this entire protest which is going on for the last 39 days. It's raining right now. Let me go across to Rahul Srivastav, who is with us at this moment. Rahul, for how long can the government afford the farmers on the borders of Delhi? It's already been 39 days. What calculation is the government working on? Because in the last couple of days with the rains, the numbers are increasing and so is the sympathy for the farmers, those who are sitting at the borders.
Ankit, the agriculture minister said one line. He says the nishkarsh jaldi hi nikal jayega. I think the term jaldi needs to be qualified all over again. Primarily because, as you're saying, 39 days. It's been long that the government has been talking to the representatives of the farm union. Both the sides are remaining entrenched as far as their stated positions are concerned. And both are not moving. The government might have given some visible signs that it is softening its stance, not ready to call them the protesters, Khalistani elements, leftists, extreme left, not attacking the farmers, and not even attempting, if you notice, Ankit, in the last few days, by calling some farm unions which are favoring the bill. I think the government has shown a certain amount of toning down as far as this political posturing against the protest and the opposition party is concerned. But there is no change as far as the bills are concerned. Now, if you notice another line significantly that the agriculture minister said, that we have to look at the entire nation. What he's trying to indicate is that they are looking at the farmers who are not protesting all over the country. And what the indication was, it remains a minuscule which is protesting. In that scenario, the government, the good thought for the government is that the farmers remain engaged. The farm unions are not giving up, and they are continuing agreeing that they will come back on the 8th and talk. But it seems that there are very few options left for the government. There is a proposal for creating some kind of a Bhavantar, which is a kind of a scheme which is prevalent in Madhya Pradesh on MSP, that who bears the difference between what is being offered to the farmer and what the MSP is. That's a tedious issue, but the government is yet to broach that. Today in the afternoon, there was a virtual breakdown after which the unions and government only agreed to meet again. And that's why I think one of the crucial elements now is the are both the sides remaining firm, refusing to create a point of convergence, and now depending on the Supreme Court to step in, create a platform through which both can resolve their issues, and then have a face-saving exit for both the sides, perhaps depending heavily on whether the Supreme Court will step in and say, create a committee and perhaps go ahead and resolve the issue. I think that seems to be the only solution left. Otherwise, the government is saying firmly no to repealing the bill, and the farmers are saying nothing but repealing the bill.
Absolutely. And the Supreme Court did, in fact, had given the government some sort of an elbow room up and an exit plan when it said, why don't you put the farm laws on the back burner till the time a committee is formed and discussions are held. The government is yet to go back to the vacation bench on that. We'll have to wait and see what happens from there. Rahul, thank you for joining us with all those details.
Hello everyone, this is Rahul Kamal here. Hope you enjoyed this video. For the latest news and analysis, like and subscribe the India Today YouTube channel, and don't forget to press the bell icon to stay updated.